Hi, I'm Shelby. Welcome to Immovable Art. Today I'm going to retell a Japanese folktale called The Crane Wife. And I'd like to start with a frame story about why this folktale has significance to me. I was in a fourth grade classroom and the teacher introduced her students to the story, and I was in the process of making a big decision for my life. And I wasn't sure which way to go. And this story helped me, which is why I'd like to tell it to you today. So let's get started. So there once was a fisherman. He lived by the sea. He'd built his house, he'd built his boat, and he'd lived happily for many, many years all by himself. But one day a storm blew in, and with it, a crane landed on his doorstep. It had a badly broken wing, and he brought that crane in, and he nursed it back to health. And then, after time passed, he set the crane free. Well, he missed that crane, and every time he went to the sea, all he could think about was the crane. Every wave that broke, he imagined a crane within that wave. And then he began thinking, perhaps I could have a wife to keep me company in my house. So, time passed again. Another storm blew in. And this time at his door was a woman, cold and hungry and needing shelter and lost. He welcomed her in. He took care of her. He gave her his bed. He gave her clothes and comfort. And soon they fell in love. And soon they were married. And everything was wonderful except the wife realized that they hadn't much money, that they were quite poor. And she told the fisherman, I can make you a beautiful quilt, a one-of-a-kind quilt that you could sell in the village and make enough for us to live for two seasons. The fisherman agreed. He said, yes, please do that. And she said, but you must promise me two things. You cannot see me work, and you cannot ask me, never ask me to make another of this kind, another quilt of this kind. And the fisherman agreed. He was already thinking about what the villagers would say about his wife and her talent, her skill. He hadn't even seen the quilt yet. Well, the next morning, after the fisherman set up a screen or a curtain for his wife to work behind, she presented him with the most exquisite quilt of its kind. I will be rich, he said. And she said, well, just see what the villagers think. Well, once he got to the village, not only were they willing to pay double, but triple for what he was asking, he was astounded. He had no idea that his wife really was so talented. And he brought home a basket full of money with dreams of perhaps buying a new boat. Or even having enough money to never have to work again. If only he could sell one more quilt. And so he asked his wife, not in seeing the sadness in her eyes, could you please make one more quilt of its kind? I have this dream. The wife, wanting to repay her husband for the kindness that he'd given her all along, said yes. And that night she went behind her screen. She went behind the curtain that the fisherman had made for her. And she fabricated, or she began to fabricate, the most beautiful quilt that she could. For she knew that her husband had a dream. That night, however, as the fishermen slept and she worked. There were cries in the room, and the fishermen stood up and went behind the curtain and said, "What's the matter, wife?" "Whoa!" And what he saw was nothing of a dream, but rather a nightmare, he believed, for a woman had become a crane as tall as his wife, and there were feathers that had been taken from her, that she had pulled from her, that she had taken from her own wing. He thought it was a nightmare. He went back to bed, and the crane, who was a crane, looked out the window at dawn's light, and she saw other cranes flying in the distance. And she was mesmerized, and she knew that if she tore off one more of her feathers, that she would not be able to fly again. Could she do that? When her husband woke up, when the fisherman woke up, she was gone, and all that was left were feathers in a basket. So, to return to our frame story, when I went in to tell the fourth grade teacher that I had made my big decision, I said only this: "Do you see any of my feathers gone? Any more of my feathers gone?" And she said, "I do not." And then tears began streaming down her face, for she knew that I was going to be flying free. And that to me was a crowning moment in my life. And how a tale can help you make a decision like that is really important. Stories are really important, and that's my story. So if you like this video, please share. Please subscribe. I have many more stories of the kind, and I want to give them. I can give them. And you can find me on Instagram. I post my art on Instagram as well as Facebook. My name's Michelle Shelby Mahan, and you can also email me if you're interested in buying one of my paintings. I have them all for sale. I have a lot of work. I sell all throughout the Pacific Northwest at art shows, so you may see me there, and that would be fantastic. Please say hello. Otherwise, I will sign off, and I'll hope to see you next time. Thank you. Bye.